Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Banjo-Kazooie on the Nintendo 64. I am One Wild Sheep yet again, and today, ladies and gentlemen, we are tackling the final battle, the final part. Now, as you remember last time, after the last credit sequence, we got kicked back into the castle by Tootie, because it's time to give the good old witch her just desserts. It's time for the final duel. Now, you remember all those collectibles, those extra goodies that we picked up way earlier on, like the notes, all of the jiggies, etc, etc. This is where we're gonna put them all to use. This is like the I love the music by here. Everything's so dramatic. It's like the perfect build-up for a final climactic battle. And this is probably the first game that I played of Rareware's that really shows how good Rareware are when it comes to final bosses and just boss fights in general, because the boss fight in this battle is just absolutely amazing. This is just like the perfect end game. It's climactic, everything works. Anyway, before we do that honeycomb puzzle by here, let's just move over to this room. And do you remember that machine Grunty was going to use in order to make herself all prettified? Well, the machine's right by here. And we can never go through this door, which is kind of strange. Actually, I got a theory about that door. I think the door, that one handle on that door is meant to be sort of like a stay over from back when this game was originally called Project Dream. I could be wrong with that, so don't quote me, but I'm pretty sure it is. I remember that sort of looking thing being used in the original version of Project Dream when it was, you know, during the videos, early videos of the game. Back when this wasn't Grunty's lair and it was Giant's lair. But I digress. Let's just walk on in here, and there's Grunty's pot itself. Now, Grunty's pot by here is actually our main key in order to access the final battle. You just jump into Ding Pot here, and you will be teleported and launched to the roof where we can take on Grunty herself. But as you can see, around this room, there are tons of note doors. Open up each of these note doors to get refills of your eggs, your feathers, etc, etc, and get an extra power-up that we're going to be wanting for this boss fight, because this upcoming boss fight is a challenging one, ladies and gentlemen. It is not the easiest boss in the world. I'm probably going to make it look easy enough, but trust me, this is a long boss fight. You need to be prepared, because this is going to be a challenging duel. So yeah, just open up all the note doors. Like I said, these are basically health refills. You know, I just got one gold feather from that. What a rip-off. You know, it would be an instant, you know, it would be an instant refill of everything if I didn't already have full, but you know, just be sure to open up these doorways, you know, it helps, it really does help. And you don't actually need all 900 notes in the game or all of the jiggies to get everything. Like, you can save a couple of notes and you can still have, ignore two jiggies of the game if you really didn't want to go out of your way to collect everything. But considering collecting is the main aim of the game, you're gonna probably want to have everything by this point, aren't you? So, yeah, go in that doorway, and that's basically an extra boost to your health, and it completely doubles your hit points. So now it's time to jump in the Ding Pot and start the final battle against Grunty herself. Ah, there we go. The music is amazing as well. Like, Grant Kirkhope, the guy who did the soundtrack for this game, he's the only person I've ever heard make a banjo, as in the instrument, banjo, the string instrument, sound epic. This boss fight is just perfect. The music is perfect. Oh, it's just so, so well done. Anyway, to start things off, Grunty will try to slide at you from each... Well, she'll just try and charge at you. When her broomstick starts to cough up and her exhaust starts failing on it, because it's apparently like a car, just jump up and peck her to do a great deal of damage. Just all I can really say. And this, ladies and gentlemen, this boss fight, it will test everything you have learnt up until this point of the game. And I think this is how final bosses should ultimately be done. Like, they train you, you know, you have to use every single skill you've been using up to this point in the game, and they're basically meant to be like a proof that you know the controls of this game. You know it through and through. And this sort of design mentality goes into the second, the boss fight of Banjo-Kazooie even more so as well, because that game has a lot of gimmicks that you need to use in the final boss. And the boss fights in the Banjo-Kazooie series are probably some of my favorite video gaming boss fights ever. They're just, every single one of them is epic. Every single one of them is just, oh, it's so good. Now, whenever she does this charging attack, you can only protect yourself from it by using a Wonder Wing. If you try to dodge it, it is impossible because it homes in on you. And now she's on her second phase. When she's on this phase, she will shoot fireballs at you and she will basically be hanging off the side of her castle. Now, what you need to do by here is simply try to lure the fireball away, jump up on the ledge and shoot eggs at her until she gets in pain. Just rinse and repeat this a couple of times until the next phase begins. What can I tell you? Seriously though, I just love the fact this boss fight is just a test of everything you learnt to this point of the playthrough. You know, you need to know how to control Banjo-Kazooie perfectly, otherwise you don't stand a chance. I mean, even with my double health as well, I'm gonna take a lot of hits. I'm going to get close to dying because this boss fight is very difficult. It's very challenging. Now, when I activated all the cheat codes and stuff for this boss fight in particular, but you don't need to. You do have more than enough generic, you know, stuff in order to take it on Grunty, but it does really help out to have extra eggs. It helps out to have the extra feathers, you know. It's, I just feel like it's perfect to be fully maxed out before this boss battle, because an upcoming section of the boss, and also she does this homing attack after every phase. In an upcoming phase of the boss, we will need to fly, which I think is, there it is. Speak of the devil. So jump on this flight pad and you will need to use flying for pretty much a large portion of this boss fight from this point onwards. Now, this is why I wanted the red feathers cheat in particular, because if it's very easy, this is the easiest point where you can screw yourself out of winning, because you will lose feathers quickly. You know, ladies and gentlemen, because you lose one feather every time you try and gain altitude, so, and you lose one feather every time you try to charge, and that eventually adds up. But just remember, use the R button in order to make tight turns. Whenever she tries to throw a fireball at you, that's either the best opportunity to charge into her, and just try and dodge the fireballs as much as you can by making very sharp turns. If you fail to make the sharp turns, and you don't, you know, if you don't dodge the fireballs, it's going to hurt. What can I say? And of course, just flat out touching her without pushing the attack button, it will hurt you, ladies and gentlemen. So just be aware of that. She still acts like a normal mook, as you'd expect, in terms of touch damage. Which doesn't really make any sense. Why would she have touch damage on you? Yeah, this game's not perfect. But yeah, like I said, some of the best times to take her out are either when she's stopping to have a rest or stopping to shoot fireballs. And she will always stop to have a rest on the opposite end of the castle where she stops to shoot her fireballs. So you can sort of play a strategy with this in order to try and get her in the right position so you can just destroy her, you can annihilate her. No problemo. I just love the music though, like the thunderbolts in the background, everything just works for this boss fight, you know, it's, I can't get over how good this final battle is. It's like the perfect ending impression you can possibly have on a game. Like, for a lot of games, a lot of games I've played, they tend to be really good throughout the entire game, but they tend to ruin things in the final boss battle. Where, I would argue, the final boss battle is one of the most important places where you make sure things are epic and climactic, because otherwise, if it isn't epic and climactic, well, it's good, it'll probably leave a bad taste on your mouth at the very end, you know, despite how good the game would be. I know people would probably be put off by the final boss and be like, the game probably wasn't as good as I thought it was, you know. I think it's more of a mental psychology thing with that, but I digress. Anyway, now she has a shield, which means, that was a stupid move, we can't actually hurt her anymore. So, remember those Jinjo buddies we've been freeing throughout the majority of our quest? Well, they are here to give us a hand against this major bitch of a witch. What can I say? Now, you basically need to go to these Jinjo statues that have spawned up. There's four of them in total. and activate them by shooting eggs into the holes. And doing so will cause the Jinjos to dive bomb and destroy Grunty. And these Jinjos are actually quite powerful creatures, which is makes me wonder, how did Grunty hide them and stop them in the first place? Because Grunty's the one that got these Jinjos lost. Grunty's the one that scattered these Jinjos throughout the levels and kept them away from their homes. So how did she manage to pull it off when the Jinjos are so bloody powerful? But then again, these Jinjos by her seem to be stronger than ones we normally get, and they are very petrified, so I assume maybe she petrified these ones to stop them from attacking her? I don't know, I'm making assumptions here. But after you destroyed all those Jinjo statues, we will have to meet the strongest of the Jinjos? We will meet the strongest of the Jinjos out there, you know? Of course, you will need a way for the statue to pop on up, so for the most part, just try and dodge her fireballs, and her fireballs do have a bit of a tracking thing going on, so she will shoot at the area you're going to be, as opposed to the area you are currently at. So just be a bit careful of that, and after a few seconds of dodging at barrages, meet the Jinjonator. Now, the mighty Jinjonator is the key to destroying this boss battle once and for all, and this here is essentially how we're gonna win. Now, Grunty's basically gonna be shooting a lot of fireballs at you, and she's then gonna send off a homing attack. When she sends off a homing attack, she will have a slight resting period until she starts shooting the fireballs again. So what I recommend you doing is dodging the fireballs by just basically running, oh my gosh, like that. Then protect yourself from the homing attack, and then basically shoot your eggs into the slots. And that's probably the best way to go about it. It takes a bit of time, but this is probably one of the easiest phases of the boss once you figure out what you're meant to do. And this is the final phase, ladies and gentlemen, the moment we get all of the Jinjo egg. Well, the moment we free this Jinjo, everything is going to work perfectly, you know? And it's usually going to take about 3 to 4 eggs in order to close up each of these holes. Now, the hitbox can be a bit dodgy at times when you're trying to shoot into the hole, but it's not that bad. It's reliable enough. And there we go. Meet the Jinjonator. Yeah. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, that is the end of Banjo-Kazooie on the Nintendo 64. This is one of my favorite games of all time. This is my favorite Nintendo 64 title, and it does so much right for the collectathon platforming genre. Every collectible has a purpose. Everything is perfect in this game in terms of collectibles. The controls, just basically moving Banjo is fun, and that's a key to a great platformer. If just controlling the character, even without the platforming obstacles, is fun, you know you got a great game, you know? The music is probably one of my favorite game soundtracks out there. Grant Kirkhope did a stunning job. It's probably in my top 5 game soundtracks of all time, you know? This is probably my top 5 games of all time. I just love this game through and through. And if any of you haven't played it, trust me, go out of your way to try it out. Get it on the N64, get it on the Xbox 360. Xbox 360 version is actually the better version, so I recommend that one. But get it on any system you can. Hell, even emulate it if you have no access to those systems, because dear God, this game is a phenomenal experience. You need to try it out. Oh, it's so good, it's so good. And it's basically the hallmark of why I considered Rareware, at least during the N64 days, to be my favorite game developer. Because everything they made was pure gold and had this level of quality to it, you know? And Rareware only get better, you know? Like, the next game, well, not the game after the next game I'm going to be tackling in the franchise, Banjo-Tooie, for example. Rareware's just done, did such a good job. They improved from a lot of things in this game in terms of, like, the story. They improved upon the story. They improved upon the characters. They improved upon the boss battles and the overall scope, you know? Even though I prefer the original Banjo-Kazooie, you know, the second game isn't to be taken lightly either, you know? They improve on a lot of things, which I'm going to talk about when I get to that LP some point in the future. But with that, ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for watching. I hope you all enjoyed. Don't be sheepish, people. And when we return next time, well, we're going to be returning with Banjo-Kazooie in the next part, because I've got a bit more to show off with this game that I am yet to do so. So thank you all for watching. Hope you all enjoy. Don't be sheepish, people. And I will catch you all then. Bye!
Bye. Oh, Woohoo! Woohoo!